Hey there everybody, it's me, Cody, on Microsoft, where today we'll be taking a look at Windows 10 build 17666 for PC. This build of Windows 10 was released today for Windows Insiders on the Fast Ring, and to those who opted in to skip ahead. We're back into that exciting phase of development for Windows Insiders with the arrival of many new features, several of which we've been hinted at for months. The sets experiment is ongoing, so Windows Insiders who previously have been testing sets will see several improvements to its functionality. Sets will now have an acrylic title bar, and the window border has been changed from your accent color to gray. These changes make sets windows look a lot more attractive, in my opinion. Alt plus Tab is changing to accommodate sets. When you use this command, you won't be limited to switching just between your open windows, but recent Microsoft Edge tabs will show up too. This way, if you're multitasking across several tabs, Alt-Tab will still be useful for you. If this isn't something you like, however, you can always change it in the Windows settings. Overall, the performance of sets is much improved in this build. The feature will continue being developed until it reaches a point where Microsoft feels it's more than comfortable with releasing it to the world in a future release of Windows. As Joe Belfiore said in his own words at Microsoft Build 2018, when we think that it is great. People have literally been asking for a clipboard history features in Windows for years. To some it may seem a little bit late, but it's finally here, and it doesn't disappoint. Using the keyboard shortcut Windows Key plus V, a brand new clipboard panel will appear. It's simple and sweet, just a little plaque which holds a list of all the different things you've copied while using your PC. You can pin certain items, delete them, or, of course, copy them to your clipboard. At the moment, clipboard history only supports plain text, HTML, and images less than 1 megabyte. Your most recent copy will work the same as always, it just won't appear in this panel if you copy something else over it. These limitations may evolve in the future. This new clipboard goes beyond your PC, and will be available on all your Windows 10 devices running this build of Windows 10 or greater. This process is powered by the same technology that runs Timeline and Sets, meaning a quick and secure exchange of information across devices. If this still makes you uncomfortable, or you'd like to configure it further, you can find a new clipboard section in the Windows settings. Another thing people have been asking for forever is a dark theme in File Explorer. Well, you've gotten what you've wanted, it's here too. File Explorer will be available in both dark and light themes matching your PC settings. Everything from the context menus to the open and save dialogues will be affected by your theme. At this point, however, the theme isn't fully applied, but we will get a more complete dark theme in a future build. It's 2018 and Notepad is being updated with several fancy new features. Announced at Microsoft Build, Notepad will support Linux line endings and Macintosh line endings in addition to Windows line endings. With this, Notepad in Windows can now correctly display text files created on these different platforms, something developers will certainly appreciate. What else is new for Notepad? Bing integration! While many of the people who found the previous change helpful will think this single-handedly eliminates all positivity towards the direction Notepad is headed, it's actually pretty useful. An unobtrusive new item in the context menus will let you search selected text in Bing, which will open in a new tab in that window. Aside from being somewhat unpredictable, finding documents with search in Windows 10 can sometimes feel like taking a shot in the dark. This build of Windows 10 tries to make search better by adding extended previews to document searches. This doesn't, unfortunately, display a preview of what the document actually looks like, but it's helpful nonetheless. Of course, the instant I try this feature out myself, the thumbnails are working. So yeah, this land snail presentation I have right here, you can see the location and the date last modified, right available for me on the search pane on the right, as well as options to open file location and to copy the full path of this document. This was a brief overview of some of the interesting new features in Windows 10 build 17666. You can take a look at the full list of fixes on our website on Microsoft.com. With all these new features, there are also quite a few issues. No, they won't cause your device to explode, but you might encounter some undocumented bug that prevents you from getting some important task done. This has been a quick build update video with me, Cody, on Microsoft. Thank you, goodbye.